Okay, so let's talk about how to solve and graph a three-part inequality. So this is a pretty simple example of a three-part inequality here. All right, so our three parts here, our left side, our middle side, our right side over there. So we are solving for x, and we do still need to get x all by itself. So in order to get x all by itself, we need to get rid of this positive 2 over here. So just think about solving equations. So the opposite of a positive 2 is a negative 2. The only difference here with the three-part inequality is that if I'm going to subtract a 2 here, I need to subtract a 2 everywhere. Also on the right-hand side, also on the left-hand side. So subtract 2 from each side, all three of them, and then simplify. So 2 minus 2 cancels. I'm going to drop down x. It's less than, let's see, 8 minus 2 is a 6, and 3 minus 2 is a 1. Drop down your symbols along with them. So this is your solution. X is less than 6, but x is greater than 1. So if we need to graph this here, so we're graphing, we are concerned with 1 and a 6. So again, when it comes to graphing, there's two main things that you need to be aware of. The first is look at your symbols so you know, do you have solid dots, open dots, parentheses, bracket type thing. So these are open dots on these numbers. That's also the same thing as parentheses. So x is less than 6, so to the left of 6, but it's greater than 1. So we are shading between this area right over here. So greater than the 1, but less than the 6. So this is what the solution would look like for this one. So let's solve another three-part inequality here. So we're working on getting x all by itself, so we need to get rid of everything else. So here we have a minus 5, so let's add that 5 to all sides. Right? Negative 5 plus 5 cancels. Let me drop down the negative 4x. Less than or equal to 7 plus 5 is 12. Negative 2 plus 5 is 3. So next thing we need to do is divide out our coefficients. So this is a negative 4 times x. We do the opposite and divide, which means everything needs to be divided by the negative 4. Negative 4 over negative 4 cancels and drop down x. Now do remember the one difference that is different in solving linear inequalities than solving equations is when you multiply or divide by a negative, you must flip the inequality symbols. So this is now a greater than or equal to. Otherwise, 12 divided by negative 4 is negative 3. This over here, I need to flip this symbol around, and I have a negative 3/4. Remember, you only flip the symbol when you multiply or divide by a negative. Otherwise, we do have this solve for x. Let's go ahead and graph here. So we're concerned with a negative 3/4 and a negative 3, and I just drew those on opposite directions here. The negative 3 and negative 3/4, it should be like that. Negative 3 is definitely smaller than negative 3/4. And let's see, x is greater than or equal to negative 3, so it's greater than that way. That's a bracket on negative 3. And x is less than the negative 3/4, so that's a parentheses on negative 3/4. Brackets on the negative 3. Otherwise, we are shading in between them.